SpaceX just surpasses United Launch Alliance in launching rockets. SpaceX charges less than United Launch Alliance for rocket launches, although United Launch Alliance rockets have historically been more dependable. This has been a truth in the space sector for the longest time, at least as far back as newfangled space stocks are concerned. According to data from S&P Global Market Intelligence, this is why SpaceX is thought to be, at best, inconsistently profitable, while Boeing and Lockheed Martin, the two companies that make up the joint venture known as the United Launch Alliance, or ULA, generate profit margins in their respective space businesses that range from 6% to 9%. However, times are a-changing. The fact is that the world has recently altered, and it did so last night with the launch of SpaceX's most recent and successful Starlink mission to place internet satellites in orbit. Will SpaceX put ULA out of business? Let's find out. Hello everyone, and welcome back to Elon Musk Evolution, where we bring you the most recent news about Elon Musk and his multi-billion dollar companies. But before we begin, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon so you don't miss any of our amazing videos. And let's check out how SpaceX and ULA compares when it comes to successfully launching rockets in space for the past few years till now. As of August 4, 2022, ULA's total stands at 152 straight successes. Every time ULA launches a rocket, it adds another point to the board and issues a press release boasting of how many times in a row it has launched a rocket with 100% mission success. While SpaceX does not, or at least does not publicly provide such a count, it does not keep track of its winning streak. And according to reports, SpaceX for the past few months got ever closer to surpassing its main competitor in space launches. But how? Let's check it out. SpaceX had successfully launched rockets into orbit 179 times as of last weekend since beginning rocket launches with a Fireball in March 2006. However, it hadn't launched successfully 179 times in a row because one of its rockets exploded 2.5 minutes into flight in 2015, and another rocket exploded while being fueled on its launch pad in September 2016. However, SpaceX and its fleet of Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets have experienced nothing but success since that time. SpaceX successfully completed its 180th launch on Sunday night, making its 153rd consecutive successful flight. By precisely one launch, SpaceX surpassed ULA's winning streak in the process. Now ULA may have a chance to catch up to SpaceX when it launches its NROL-91 mission the following week. However, it may not, given the rate at which SpaceX is launching rockets, which suggests that it may have already pulled even farther ahead by then. It's also a foregone conclusion that SpaceX, or ULA for that matter, will experience an anomaly at some point in the future and ruin its winning streak. The first stage of SpaceX's Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets, which have respective costs of $62 million and $90 million, is reusable. Additionally, they are working on the Starship, a fully reusable Mars transportation rocket. The launch contract for the U.S. government has been exclusively held by ULA since 2006. This monopoly was broken in 2014 when the U.S. Air Force authorized Falcon 9 to compete for high-profile launch contracts. So the question is, will SpaceX drive ULA out of business? No, not in the near future. However, SpaceX and Blue Origin will force ULA out of business over the next 5 to 10 years. The joint venture between Boeing and Lockheed Martin is called United Launch Alliance. These two businesses were fierce rivals before 2006 and were engaged in lengthy legal disputes. In order to put an end to their legal dispute, they chose to establish a 50-50 partnership corporation in 2006. They thus established the ULA. When this arrangement first began, SpaceX complained to the FTC, claiming it was illegal since it would lead to a monopoly, hinder innovation, and raise the price of government satellite launches. Nobody was aware of Elon Musk or SpaceX at the time. SpaceX also failed to enter orbit, therefore nobody was concerned about the protest. Boeing and Lockheed claimed that a partnership would allow for greater innovation and would combine the knowledge and experience of both businesses into a single entity. ULA was created as a result. The CEO of ULA has stated on several occasions that he is not concerned about SpaceX. Reusable rockets are not, in his opinion, the wave of the future. Every industry has experienced disruption, where a fresh creative firm drives away an established market leader. Even the dominant search engine at the time, Yahoo, didn't take Google seriously. Even the founder of Google sought to sell it to Yahoo, but Yahoo turned him down. Blockbuster predated Netflix. They were oblivious to the potential of streaming services in a society where everyone had access to the internet. The Blockbuster management team believed their company would last forever. Many business veterans, including Steve Ballmer, the CEO of Microsoft, laughed at Apple when Steve Jobs unveiled the iPhone. The absence of a keyboard on the iPhone was a point of contention for BlackBerry. In light of this, it is a poor email system. Nokia failed to adjust to a shifting smartphone industry, and Apple and Samsung gained a larger part of the market overall. Selling celluloid cameras and films were a huge business for Kodak, but the advent of digital cameras forced them out of business. These numerous examples serve to demonstrate how failing to innovate and adapt will lead to a company's demise. The rocket engine is created and designed by SpaceX. SpaceX created the Merlin engine for the Falcon series of rockets, which runs on rocket-grade kerosene, RP-1, and liquid oxygen, or LOX. They discovered that RP-1 is not the ideal fuel for reusable rockets during the reuse of the Falcon first stage. As a result, they began to create the Raptor engine in 2011 that runs on methane, CH4, and LOX. The Super Heavy and Starships built by SpaceX now use this engine. On the other hand, ULA has never created any rocket engines during its existence. The RD-180 engine from Russia powers the Atlas V, the RS-68A, RL-10 engine from the Aerojet Rocketdyne powers the Delta IV Heavy, and the BE-4 engine from Blue Origin powers the Vulcan, the next-generation rocket. ULA does not possess a competitive advantage over SpaceX in the development of rocket engines. The most expensive component of a rocket is the engine. How can ULA compete with SpaceX's in-house Raptor and Merlin engine? ULA hasn't tried to create a rocket engine since 2006, though, and now it's too late. At the moment, Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy are SpaceX's two operating rockets. In low Earth orbit and geo-transfer orbit, respectively, Falcon 9 can launch 22,800 kilograms and 8,300 kilograms at a launch price of about $60 million. With a launch capacity of 26,700 kilograms for GTO and 63,800 kilograms for LEO, the Falcon Heavy is an affordable $90 million launch vehicle. Two other rockets are in use by ULA, Atlas V as well as Delta IV Heavy, which is also known as the Atlas V. The Atlas V costs $110 million and has a launch capacity of 8,900 kilograms for GEO and 20,520 kilograms for LEO, or low Earth orbit. With a cost of $400 million on average, the Delta IV Heavy can launch satellites weighing 28,790 kilograms for LEO and 14,220 kilograms to geo-transfer orbit. SpaceX easily defeats ULA's launch vehicle in every way. It's obvious. SpaceX is also currently developing and testing the Starship. It has an aspirational $2 million launch cost and is capable of launching 100,000 kilograms or 220,000 pounds to low Earth orbit. It's evident that ULA's rocket cannot even match SpaceX's existing rocket. As a result, when Starship goes online, ULA's rocket will be far behind. Reusable rockets have always been a priority for SpaceX, and the Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy were designed to have a maximum number of reuses of 10 without extensive refurbishment. It's disappointing to see ULA's rate of innovation. By the time they launch their Vulcan rocket, SpaceX will have launched a fully reusable cargo Starship from Mars, and the new Glenn reusable rockets also being developed by Blue Origin. As a result, in the competition for reusable rockets, ULA will fall short to both SpaceX and Blue Origin. And that ends today's video. We sincerely hope you enjoyed it. Hey, make sure you like it and share it with your friends and family. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to see even more great videos from us. And we'll do it again next time. Thanks for watching.